Joining me now from New York City is Mike Baco. He's sports editor with the DailyNational.com. Mike, how big is baseball in China compared to more established sports that we see there, basketball, soccer, or football?
Well, I think you mentioned it right there, right at the top. Basketball is the number one sport right now that we would recognize in China. You have some established stars that have already played over here in the U.S., like Yao Ming, an international treasure there in China. What the Chinese are hoping for now, and what the U.S. MLB is hoping for now, is that one player from China can come over and almost be their Yao Ming, or from Japan, their Ichiro Suzuki, or from many years back, Hideo Nomo, when he came over and played with the Dodgers. Just getting that one athlete that the general public, school children, amateurs that are playing or that want to play can hold on to and show as their beacon to say, hey, you know what? This person did it. I could do it if I train, if I follow some of these initiatives that are happening in schools. That could be their entryway into the U.S. and to Major League Baseball.
And we did hear that the Milwaukee Brewers just picked up three young Chinese players. Is that a start? How significant is that?
Oh, I mean, that any little thing is a start. And like you said, what the Brewers are doing, what Major League Baseball is doing in terms of pouring money and infrastructure into teaching the game, getting fields built. One of the big challenges right now in China is that not only are they not too familiar with the game, but they don't have the infrastructure and the fields to play. It's very easy to go out and put up a basketball hoop or even to have a three-on-three game, but you really need some infrastructure and you need fields to actually play baseball, to get better at baseball. So that's something that Major League Baseball is doing. Certainly the Brewers are pouring money into it, into their scouting. And I think what Major League Baseball teams will see, much like they did in Latin American countries, if they pour money into building up infrastructure, pour money into finding some of those diamonds in the roughs like the Brewers were able to do there, it will be beneficial to them in the long run.
You and I have talked about this before. We know that other U.S.-based professional leagues have been making for some time now a huge push into China, as you said, the NBA, even the National Hockey League, MLB right now. Do they all have the same goals when it comes to recruiting and building this fan base? Are they all on the same page here?
Well, let me give you some facts and figures. Tencent, the giant internet company there in China, has a $500 million deal to stream and to show the NBA game rights there in China. So that's something that's way off in the future right now for Major League Baseball and for NHL and for the NFL. But if they can make inroads, you're looking at hundreds of millions of dollars. You're looking at hundreds of millions of potential fans. All of these leagues are being tasked with growing their fan base, and there's only so much growing that you could do here in the States. If anything, all professional sports are seeing a slightly diminished nature to their, you know, ratings, people finding other things to do, sports not being as popular. We're talking about popularity of baseball in China. It's facing some struggles here in the U.S., so they're looking for more audience. They're looking to grow their revenue, and the way to do that is to build more fans.
You mentioned that infrastructure is one of the challenges for baseball in China. But what more needs to be done to grow this sport? We heard that there are these three development centers. Is it about getting kids to start young?
Yeah, it's absolutely about getting kids to start young, not only playing, but becoming fans. One of the things that you mentioned that Major League Baseball is doing is having these initiatives in the schools. They have about 100 play ball initiatives right now that baseball is being exposed to about 100 million school children in China. So that's a good start. One of the other things that is also interesting is now that baseball is going to be an Olympic sport, that also can build up some common fan, interest as we point to 2020. But Major League Baseball just needs to keep doing what it's doing. It's not going to be a short-term fix. This is going to be something that we're not going to see the fruits of 5 years, 10 years from now. We're going to be seeing it maybe 20 years from now when, much like now, it's not uncommon to see a player coming from a Latin American country, coming from Japan. What Major League Baseball probably wants to see is in 20 years, it not being such a big deal that players are coming from China, that it becomes the norm. But it's going to be a long-term effort. A lot of infrastructure, again, needs to be built up. But Major League Baseball seems to be in it for the long haul.
Mike Baco in New York, always great to see you. Thank you so much.
Always great to see you.